Hello from Seoul. Many of you think making fried rice is difficult. That's why I brought this. Today, I'll show you the simplest fried rice that you can make in 5 minutes and 3 more super easy fried rice. You already like it, don't you? After watching this video, I'm sure you will be a master of fried rice. Okay, let's get started.
As you expect, the most important ingredient is rice. I think long grain rice such as jasmine rice is the best for fried rice because they stay fluffy and separate after cooking. But most of you don't keep a variety of rice in your pantry, right? Same here. So, as always, just use whatever you have in your kitchen. For information, this kind of short grain rice is stickier than the long grain rice. So, if you are using short grain rice, you can either put less water or cool it down on a white plate for a while. This way, you can get rid of the stickiness and coat every single grain of the rice deliciously. If you skip this step, it's gonna be hard to stir fry it and it may get mushy. If your fried rice was not good, I think this was the problem. Some of you might wanna say, hey Aaron, what if I don't even know how to cook the rice properly? Don't worry about it, here's the tip. Today, I'm gonna use this product. This is pre-cooked rice, so you just need to put it in the microwave. But before you microwave it, it is very dry, which means it's perfect for your fried rice. Think about all the steps, washing the rice, cooking, and cooling. To people who don't eat rice every day, it can be overwhelming. That's why I'm saying this is more convenient. But you know what? I'm not sponsored. FYI, I've never been. Call me, please. Okay, let me start with the easiest one, egg fried rice. Crack 2 eggs in a bowl and beat it. We're gonna put the rice here and fry it in a pan together. Whisk it until everything is mixed well. Of course, you can fry the eggs in a pan first and then add some rice, but to make it simple, just dump this rice into this egg pool. This is kind of fried rice 101. We don't need any fancy skills or something like that. Now, let's add some seasoning. While frying the rice, adding lots of seasoning at the right time can be hard. So I'll just add all the seasoning now. This is way easier. And you can use any kind of seasoning such as salt, soy sauce, oyster sauce, or chicken stock. But let me use this oyster sauce this time because it really goes well with eggs. Put 1 tablespoon of oyster sauce and add 1 tablespoon of cooking oil. In this step, you can use any oil, but I recommend you to avoid anything with a strong flavor like extra virgin olive oil. Here's my favorite green onion time. Chop the green onion first. We're gonna use 2 parts evenly. I'm gonna use this white part for making green onion oil, and this green part is for the texture and the beautiful presentation. You can chop it into the size you want or just simply cut it with scissors like this. Then you don't even need to wash your cutting board. Bye bye, lots of dishes. Put some oil on a pan and make some green onion oil with the white part. I mean, less green part. When you feel the amazing aroma from the green onions, change the heat to high heat and add the rice. The most important thing in this step is you need to keep stirring. Some of you might wanna ask, isn't it too watery or too many eggs? But trust me, this is exactly the amount that we're looking for. It's like when you make scrambled eggs, you feel like you prepared a lot of eggs, but after you finish cooking, it is not so much, right? This is the same thing. Don't worry, you'll be fine. Once you feel like every single grain of the rice is coated well with the egg, put the rest of the green onions and fry for another minute. If you wanna add more ingredients, now is the time because it's okay to fry the rice for a long time. I think it's done. This is a super simple fried rice, but let's see how it tastes. Let's call our taste tester.
Claire.
맛있겠군. Ready? 볶음밥이 가져야 할 충족 조건을 잘 갖췄어. 뭔가 이렇게 끈적지고 혹은 뭐 이렇게 덩어리진 거 그런 게 전혀 없고 밥알이 하나하나 코팅된 게 입안에서 딱 느껴져. 크게 많은 재료가 들어간 것도 아닌데도 너무 맛있네. For your information, I'm a big fan of eggs. But to some people who don't like eggs, they say eggs tend to have some kind of unpleasant smell, you know what I mean? So anyways, if you make green onion oil first, then you can feel it. That's why Aaron is addicted to green onion. So why don't you give it a shot?
The second one is shrimp fried rice. Shrimps will make your fried rice look fancier in front of your guests. Of course, it will be a little bit more complicated than the first one, but still, it's gonna be super easy. Don't worry about it. You will be needing some shrimp, egg, green onion, and carrot. Carrot doesn't affect the taste much, but add some for a beautiful color. I don't buy it, but if you keep saying you don't have a carrot in your kitchen, you can skip it. First of all, chop the green onion and the carrot. How you cut the green onion doesn't really matter, but the carrot needs some time to be fully cooked, so I recommend you to cut it as thinly as possible. Then people can avoid eating carrots. Lovely, right? Why don't you try it to your family or friends? Just like before, add the green onions with some oil and make the green onion oil first. But this time, I recommend you to add more oil than before since we have more ingredients to fry. About 2 tablespoons will be enough. Crack an egg into a pan and stir it quickly. Can you guys guess what's coming next? Most of you might say carrots, but nope, not yet. I'll add the rice first. Generally, if you put the veggies before the rice, the water comes up from the veggies continuously, and eventually, it will make your fried rice too mushy. But this time, we have only carrots, so it's not gonna be a problem, but if you have more veggies for your fried rice, then make sure to follow the order. Now, move the rice in one corner, and put a half tablespoon of soy sauce. It will make the sizzling sound, which gives the flame flavor that we're looking for. Add a half tablespoon of oyster sauce, and stir fry it. Now, add some carrot and shrimp. You can use cocktail shrimp or just cooked shrimp, but don't use raw shrimp because it holds a lot of water. Again, you need to keep the rice dry. This is the key. Lastly, add 1 teaspoon of fish sauce and fry for another minute. Some of you might say, no way, because you don't like fishy taste. But don't worry about it, Claire and I hate fishy taste either. Claire even told me when she was a little kid, she used to think like she would not marry someone who eats a lot of fish because she didn't want her house to be full of fishy smell. So don't worry about it and trust me, it will just bring amazing umami flavor. I think it's done. Let's put this fried rice on a plate nicely. How does it look?
Claire?
이야, 새우 좀 넣었다고 확실히 비주얼이 산다. 음. Some people don't want to put fishy sauce in their food because they are afraid of fishy taste or fishy smell. But trust me, I don't like it either. But if you put it in, I feel like it makes the dish more flavorful. You can feel more umami flavor.
We made fried rice with seafood, so let's use meat this time. Again, let me guess what you have in your fridge. Bacon, don't you? You don't have it? Come on, you checked the only fridge. I'm sure you have some in your freezer. Dig to the bottom of your freezer. Chop the bacon into small pieces as if no one knows there's bacon in it. In the same sense, I kind of prefer to use ground pork because I don't even need to chop it. Again, we still need to chop the green onion because it's your favorite. I still have a lot of chopped carrots, so let me use this again. Lastly, potato. I don't know why, but I feel like potatoes upgrade to better fried rice. Anyways, let's chop the potato, but chop it into very small pieces so that nobody can feel it. If you chop the ingredients into small pieces like this, people won't notice what makes your fried rice so special, but they will constantly ask you to make it again. This is my kick. Let's put the bacon first. Some of you might wanna say, hey Aaron, you forgot something, your favorite green onion. No, I meant it. If you put the green onion first, it will burn while the bacon is cooked. But for this, never mind. Since I chopped it into small pieces, it doesn't take so long, so I shouldn't fry them together. Now it's time for the eggs, but it's optional, depending on how you feel. Claire prefers to eat sunny side up on the fried rice, so I'm not gonna add egg this time. When you feel the amazing aroma from the green onions, move them in one corner and add 1 tablespoon of soy sauce into the pan and stir it all together. Add the rice and stir fry it again. This time, let me use a half tablespoon of chicken stock instead of oyster sauce. As I already said, you can add any seasoning that you want. This time, I don't want my fried rice to be too dark, so I'm using chicken stock. Lastly, veggies. Potatoes and carrots need some time to be fully cooked, so make sure to fry them long enough so that they are fully cooked. Otherwise, you might taste undercooked potatoes and carrots. That's why I said chop them into small pieces. Seriously, I planned it. Put the rice on a plate and place the sunny side up on top. It's done.
Claire?
I need to break the beauty of this fried rice. Mmm, 맛이 없을래야 맛이 없을 수가 없어. This egg yolk definitely works like a sauce. So that's why I love sunny side up. 자기가 확실히 재료들을 다 작게 작게 썰었잖아. 작게 작게 썰었잖아. 그래서 한 입에 넣었었을 때 그 재료들이 밥알이랑 같이 막 날아가는 것 같아.
The last one is kimchi fried rice. Many of you have been asking for this, so here's the present. I'll show you a super easy version. You have been needed pretty much the same ingredients as before. Kimchi, bacon, green onion, and rice. If you have these four ingredients, you are ready to start. Just like before, it is key to chop the bacon and green onion into small pieces. I'm pretty sure your friend will ask you like, what did you put in your fried rice? It is so delicious. But they will never know what's the secret. Put some kimchi in a bowl and chop them into small pieces with scissors. If you cut it into big pieces, it can be a little bit salty when you have a bite. So I recommend you to cut them into small pieces. In this step, you probably want to know how much kimchi we need. I'll say half the amount of rice would be enough. Put some oil on a pan and fry the bacon first. Add the green onions. Move them in one corner and add 1 tablespoon of soy sauce. This soy sauce is not really for the seasoning but for the flame flavor. Now add the kimchi and stir it. Put 1 tablespoon of chili pepper flakes. I'll say this is necessary because it will make your kimchi fried rice look prettier. But if you really don't have it, you can skip it. Add a half teaspoon of sugar and stir fry for at least 3 minutes. Lastly, put some rice into it. That's it. Easy, right? But some of you are still worried that you might burn the rice because of lots of seasoning from kimchi. But don't worry about it. I'm here for you guys. There are two ways. First, just turn off the stove and mix the rice with kimchi. And then when you're done, turn the heat back on. Simple, right? Whatever you cook, unless you're grilling the steak, it's okay to turn off the heat for a short time. No worries. The second way is to add 1 tablespoon of water. This will prevent your food from burning. Also, if you are using short grain rice, it might be hard to mix it because they are sticking together. In that case, you can simply add a little bit of water and mix it. The water will go away eventually. So don't be afraid of putting some water in your food. I think it's ready. Let's call our taste tester.
Claire.
아주 그린 어니언 파티를 열으셨어. Obviously, this is the best part, right? 맛있겠다. 다양한 야채들 넣어가지고 이것저것 한 볶음밥도 당연히 건강 생각하면 훨씬 더 좋기는 한데 이 김치에 김치 하나를 이기기가 조금 힘들다. 좀 너무 강력하긴 하다 얘가 맛이. 김치 자체가 매콤하기도 하고 시큼하기도 하잖아. 그래서 그런지 느끼할 만한 볶음밥인데도 확실히 김치랑 하면은 그 느끼함이 좀 덜한 것 같아. 나 김치볶음밥만 보면은 맨날 생각나는 거 뭔지 알아? 나 신혼 때 이렇게 쉬운 김치볶음밥을 내가 망했잖아. 왜 이렇게 쉬운데 왜 이렇게 망한 걸까 나는? 이렇게 쉬운 걸 왜 못한 걸까 나는? If you screw up making kimchi fried rice, your cooking level is like my level.
Today, I showed you 4 different types of fried rice. You might feel like they are lazy versions, but they are the basics for making fried rice. Once you learn something from this video and practice, you can cook any type of fried rice with no fear. I think it's a matter of time you become a master of fried rice. Alright, this is it for today, and I'll see you next time.